All right, there's a lot of frost on the ground. It's very cold out. But that's not so much a problem as my gut is this day as well. Now, I woke up at 3 with, I felt fine. And then all of a sudden, within a half hour, because I was still awake, my gut started hurting again. Similar to yesterday. Now, I didn't wake up with a dead feeling and then eventual pain like all morning yesterday. It's slightly reduced today, but it still happened. The pain still came back, so something went wrong. I think I did a lot of things wrong that led to this pain. I ate those snack potato chips. I ate 2 bags of those and then that popcorn. I've been eating a lot of the white bread from the free meals. I've been eating white rice, and I've read that in a study between North India and South India, the people in South India tended to eat more rice, and the people in North India tended to eat more wheat. And there were higher incidences of stomach cancer from the Southern Indians because they ate more rice. I'm thinking rice, it could be negatively contributing. I ate a few smoked oysters, canned smoked oysters, and I think smoked foods are bad for the gut. I also believe that coffee, any dark foods like that, like coffee, are hard on the gut. So I need to eliminate those. I need to get more whole wheat. I know I've changed my diet a lot. I think those snack foods, though, with the vinegar, really set me on a downward spiral and made it hard. I mean, when I was walking yesterday, it was taking a lot of energy out of me to deal with the pain. So it was like almost exercising. I could imagine what it's like to be older and to have joint pains and stuff. That pain, dealing with it, takes extra energy out of you. It's not like being a kid where you're perfectly healthy. You don't burn a lot of... You might burn more efficiently as a kid because you're feeling fine and the only exercise you're getting is the exercise itself. Whereas older people deal with pain, or sick people even. It just weakens you. It's weakened me. And it's slowed me down. I gotta relax more. I've been relaxing already enough because there's not many places to really exercise. These past few cities I've been in, I haven't been able to do any upper body strength training with my suspension trainer, or I haven't been able to carve any Indian club, caveman club deal. I was kind of close in Lacey. There was a fallen log I could have chopped up that was isolated and around a loud area where no one would even hear me chopping. Man, I didn't realize it until it was too late that was a good opportunity. And at that point, I was ready to leave the area, ready to leave Lacey. Yeah, as I speak, I'm feeling it. It feels like I have to fart, and if I farted, I'd get a relief. And that's kind of what happened in the past, but I think this is a little more serious than that now. I think this pain is actual real damage and not just a buildup of gas. I do get some relief when I get on all fours on my hands and knees and just sit there and stretch my stomach, okay? That contributes to less pain, all right? But it's so difficult to get into those yoga positions. You probably can understand how hard it is for a homeless person to do various things without drawing a lot of attention. I don't really have anywhere that's isolated enough to get away with doing a good stomach stretch like that, you know, and hold that pose for 5-10 minutes. I would, if I had a home, I would do, if, or just any, you know, if I could lock myself in a bathroom or something, I would do that. I do that sometimes when I have to poop. In the past, I'd, you know, if it was a bathroom stall and not many people came, I would just get on my hands and knees and stretch my stomach for relief.